Hey, welcome back to another edition of Babyface Brew Review. My name is Alex. I'll be walking you guys and gals through this review for the next few moments here today. As you can see, we're looking at Melvin Brewing Company out of Alpine, Wyoming. They do some really killer stuff in regards to their IPAs, double IPAs. Today, we're looking at a 13% triple IPA. This is Lambda, Lambda, Lambda. This beer, I've not had it yet. I've had a lot of Melvin beers. I've really enjoyed pretty much everything I've had from them. They actually recently opened up a tap room in the Bellingham, Washington area, about an hour and a half north of Seattle, just up Interstate 5. They've done some really killer stuff in regards to collaborations. They just had their 6x9 but with Alpine, which is really good. They collaborated in 2016 with Sierra Nevada on the Moxymoron Imperial Session IPA, which was one of the better ones out of that pack. So if you've not heard of Melvin, they definitely should be on your radar. This beer from the accolades, we're looking at about 4.09 out of 5, which puts in that exceptional category on Beer Advocate. From Untappd, you're looking at 4.12 out of 5 caps from about 4,000 ratings. So really, really good stuff here. They're using, it's like 7 or 8 different kinds of hops in this beer. I'll read them off to you real quick. Citra, Lewis, Chinook, Amarillo, Gilbert, Columbus, Takashi, Mosaic, Simcoe, and Lamar. So some really, really a ton of hops there. I've never heard of Gilbert or Lamar or Takahashi, so excuse me if I'm not familiar with that. Maybe that's a joke, but they said they're dry hopping with like 4 pounds of Mosaic and Citra in this one. So just awesome, awesome stuff. I'm sure it has a pretty big mash bill for being 13%. So going to be a very big and probably sticky beer if we're and dank as well from Melvin. That's generally what we expect from them. So alcohol by volume, 13%. Like I said, 100 IBUs. Canning date, I believe, was on the bottom here, 11/6/17. So just over a month old. In a can, though, so probably still relatively fresh. So other than that, let's crack the cap and see what's going on with the Melvin Lambda 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 Triple IPA. Got a little snifter here, almost probably going to be similar to like a barley wine, maybe in drinkability, we'll see. Pour most of it in there, not all of it. Really nice clarity to this beer, kind of like a golden orange, almost like a dark honey type color. Really, really nice. Beautiful head. About a finger and a half worth of cap there, and really tightly compact bubbles. Off white in terms of complexion of the head. Some mild carbonation streaming up from the bottom as well. Really nice looking stuff. If we swirl it around, see if we get any glass legs or alcohol legs and glass lacing, some sticky glass lacing. Yeah, we can see some mounting at the top there. But really nice looking beer in the glass. My God. All right, let's get aroma and smell on this bad boy. Wow. Big juicy fruit notes. I get citrus zest, orange, like a candied grapefruit as well. I also get some pine needles, a little bit of a dankness, big sweet caramel malt in there, pale malt, some honey sweetness, almost like a syrupy sweetness, maybe a touch of alcohol. Really nice smelling stuff. Some pineapple as well. Yeah, my mouth's watering. Let's dive in. Cheers, pros. This is the Melvin Lambda 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 Triple IPA. Wow, that's really good. Beautiful glass lacing too. My God. Up front, like big orange juice, like really nice, fresh squeezed orange juice. Then I get a little bit of some grapefruit, but I get, you know, mainly a little bit of tropical fruit coming out after that big orange juice. I get pineapple, maybe a little bit of mango sweetness to that as well. Then a big honey, caramelized malt, big honey syrupy sweetness coming out middle of the mouth, and then back end it kind of turns into more of that orange zest, orange peel bitterness, a little bit of like pine needle or like forest flory like dankness to that. Not as dank as some of the other Melvin beers, but there is definitely some lingering dankness on the back end. It's really nice. What I'm most impressed about is the drinkability for a 13% beer. Getting into that, I've had Waldo's the last couple years, which is typically 12.2, 12.7 or something like that. They label that a triple IPA by Lagunitas. This drinks better than that. Now, that might be more flavorful, more dank, more aromatic in your face, but this is much more drinkable in terms of a triple IPA, not to just kind of pigeonhole and compare it to one. But that's what I think when I think triple IPA. I think Waldo's dank, you know. But that is, you know, that's really cool to see because this one is so smooth in terms of the aftertaste. It's a medium to fullish body. That carbonation is nice. It's keeping it, you know, moving throughout the palate. It's keeping it drinkable as well. The booze is really well hidden. I get a little bit of warming in the chest, but it's not burning at all on the back. It's really silky smooth. This is really, really nice stuff. Not cloyingly sweet either. Yeah, I just get huge orange, grapefruit notes, some pine needle. Really, really nice. Wow. Definitely one of the better ones I've had. As for a grade, I'm going to go right around like 92. It's a really fun beer. It's really cool. I couldn't drink like one more of these. I mean, if I drank one more of those, I'd be in a good spot, you know, mentally. But it's just really big. It's very sweet. If you like sweet, it's going to be right up your alley. It's not dry finishing at all. You have a mash bill that big, you're bound to get some of those sugars coming out. So 92 for me, but that's not what matters. It matters what you guys and gals think. So you can let me know by leaving that all down below in the comment section. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Let me know. What beers can I review next? What beers are you guys drinking? You want to trade a beer with me? Let me know by leaving it down below in the comment section. Thank you so much again. Until next time. Cheers, pros. Thank you so much for stopping by the Face Brew Review.